In this video, I'm exploring the real reason you struggle to hear in background noise. Coming up. Hi guys, Cliff Olson, Doctor of Audiology and founder of Applied Hearing Solutions in Phoenix, Arizona. And on this channel, I cover a bunch of hearing related information to help make you a better informed consumer. So if you're into that, make sure you hit that subscribe button. And don't forget to click the bell to receive a notification every time I post a new video. You know that feeling of complete mental and physical exhaustion that you get inside of a noisy environment, straining to hear someone who's talking to you? That is, if you don't completely avoid those situations altogether. The reason you get this feeling is because it takes a lot of work for your brain to actually separate speech from background noise. This separation of speech and noise becomes increasingly more difficult if you have a hearing loss, because less auditory information can make it up to the auditory processing centers of your brain. There is not a single person with hearing loss that does not want to hear better in background noise, and this leads us to constantly look for a hearing aid that can do a better job of separating speech and noise. The problem is, relying only on state-of-the-art hearing aid technology to help separate speech from the background noise overlooks perhaps the most important factor when it comes to being able to do this, and that factor is cognition. In a recent article published in Ear and Hearing titled Listening Effort: How the Cognitive Consequences of Acoustic Challenge Are Reflected in Brain and Behavior, the author stated that listening to degraded speech is a challenging task that requires listeners to devote additional cognitive resources for successful understanding, reflected in greater neural activity, increased pupil dilation, and behavior. The author went on to say that acoustic challenge is thus not merely an auditory problem, but it significantly affects a variety of cognitive operations required for both linguistic and non-linguistic tasks. Simply put, background noise degrades speech to the point where hearing aids alone may not be enough to help you hear better in a noisy environment. This means that if you want to hear better in background noise, you have to be able to handle the additional cognitive load required to understand speech when there's noise around. Therefore, understanding how well you should expect to hear in a background noise situation really depends on how well you perform cognitively. Yet, evaluating your cognitive brain function is something that has been long overlooked by hearing care professionals. That's why CogniView, today's video sponsor, has developed a way to evaluate your cognitive performance using their CogniView Thrive system. CogniView Thrive is a computerized cognitive screening tool that allows your hearing care professional to evaluate how your brain performs to see if cognitive impairment is impacting your ability to hear. The 5-minute evaluation is designed to measure 3 key domains of cognition, including memory, which is your ability to store and recall information when needed, visual-spatial, which is your ability to process and interpret visual information about yourself and your surroundings, and executive function, which is your ability to concentrate and problem solve. It also measures 2 speed performance domains, including reaction time, which is your ability to react to situations, and processing speed, which is the time that it takes to mentally process a task. If your performance in any of these domains falls into the yellow or red categories, then it is highly likely that they are impairing your ability to process speech in a background noise situation. Until you understand how well you perform cognitively, it's very difficult to know if the amount of effort you put into listening is due to your hearing loss or if it's due to your cognition. The good news is, the information obtained in this screening can help your hearing care professional identify if cognitive decline is contributing to your difficulty. It can help them identify the need for additional audiologic testing, or it can even lead to a physician referral for additional cognitive testing. The results obtained from the CogniView Thrive screening can also lead to a better treatment recommendation from your hearing care professional to help you hear your absolute best in background noise with as little listening effort as possible. For example, if you happen to score in the yellow or red categories in any of these domains, your hearing care professional may actually recommend an assistive listening device like a remote microphone that can help cut through background noise so you can understand speech significantly better. Over time, your hearing care professional can even use the CogniView Thrive system to see if auditory stimulation using hearing treatment is actually having a positive impact on your cognition. After all, with all the research coming out linking hearing loss and dementia, monitoring your cognitive performance should be high on your priority list if you have a hearing loss. Okay, at this point, you're probably thinking, Dr. Cliff, I get it. I should be having my cognitive performance evaluated, but where the heck do I find a hearing care professional who actually has the Cognitive You Thrive system? Well, all you have to do is go to earbrain.com and click on Find an Audiologist. This way, you can enter your zip code to find your closest Cognitive You provider. If you do not have an audiologist near you who has the Cognitive You Thrive system, or if you already have an audiologist that does not have Cognitive You, then click on Can't Find the Right AUD, and Cognitive You will reach out to providers in your area on your behalf. At the end of the day, everybody with hearing loss wants to hear better in background noise. But until you have a full understanding of your hearing loss and your overall cognitive performance, you may never actually receive the right treatment to accomplish it. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below. If you liked the video, please share it. And if you want to see other videos just like this one, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Also, feel free to check out my website, drcliffaud.com.